when you are just alone with the stars. It is an indescribable moment. Some of the lights are coming from 10 billion light years away. So we are really seeing the first stars, and I feel like astronomy allows us to time travel. I shared my discovery with my family and they didn't react much. Then the media started to cover it, and then my parents and my sister start calling, okay, what did you do really? Everyone's asking about this discovery, what's going on? And I was saying, I have been talking about this for months and now you are asking me. I am Burçin Mutlu-Pakdil and I am an astrophysicist, and I study how galaxies form and evolve. My grandparents didn't have an opportunity to learn, read and write. For my parents, at that time in Turkey, women help with the household, get married and have families. Mom basically followed that trend. They didn't have role models. They didn't know how to dream about bigger things. As long as I can remember myself, I was always so curious, and I said, I want to be the cleverest person in the world. And I asked my sister, who is the cleverest person in the world? And my sister said, maybe Einstein. I learned more about physics and the space, and I became obsessed about black holes especially. But I wasn't sure I can do astronomy as a job, because I didn't see many role models around me. I did my undergrad degree in Ankara, capital city of Turkey. And the first day I met with one of the faculty members, and he basically said, you are a woman and you are planning to study physics. Are you sure? Are you crazy? He basically challenged me with this question, and I didn't know how to react. I kept going, but it was so challenging. And at the time, there was a hijab ban overall in Turkey. Several protests were going on. And for my parents, they were so worried about that, they didn't want me to practice hijab. I was using hats and other stuff to cover certain parts of my body. But you know, this really alienates you from everyone. Like, you feel awkward among your peers. So I decided to do my higher education in America. When I walked in my ceremony, graduation ceremony, the university was live streaming it, and my parents were all like watching it. They were so proud of it. Being yourself, expressing yourself freely is an incredible freedom, and I really needed that, especially when you are like dealing with the biggest questions. You need to free all these distractions, you know. You should be comfortable to just focus on these big questions. I really want to understand how galaxies form and what is the nature of dark matter. Galaxies are systems of stars, planets, black holes, and gas all glued together by dark matter. 80% of matter is dark matter. We cannot observe it. We only know its existence through its effect on regular matter. And since it makes most of the universe, it really plays a fundamental role in galaxy formation. Dwarf galaxies are the most dark matter dominated systems, and these galaxies might only host thousands or hundreds of stars compared to Milky Way with billions of stars. We think they might be the first galaxies formed ever. 15 years ago, we only knew a dozen dwarf galaxies, and now this number reaches around 60, and we expect to even discover hundreds of dwarf galaxies around Milky Way. Each dark matter model predicts a different number of dwarf galaxies. How many we discovered might help us understand how dark matter particles interact with each other. We are connected to the Tololo Observatory in Chile. I am already just waiting for the control. Hi.
Okay, go ahead, Burçin. You have control.
Now we are controlling all machines there. I have all these cool informations about temperature, humidity, pressure, wind. When the conditions are good, we directly point our telescope to that direction. So since it is really competitive and expensive to use these telescopes, every second matters. For the first time, we will be able to cover the southern sky with enough depth that we will be able to reach the faint stars, and we will be able to discover the faintest ultra-faint dwarf galaxies around Milky Way. These dots over here, these are stars. Being part of the process of uncovering new knowledge, it is indescribable satisfaction. When I first published my paper, scientific paper, I felt like I had a new baby. Everything started when our team was observing approximately 10 years ago a spiral galaxy and noticed this peculiar system in the background. A very symmetric system. Generally, rings form when two galaxies crash. This kind of wild interactions creates a lot of asymmetries and connections between ring and central body. But in this galaxy, basically so symmetric, and between the central body and the outer ring, there's no connection. And I said, I really want to do a detailed study on it. I basically modeled the central bright structure, blocking intense light to see if there's anything hidden in it. The first time that I realized that, oh my God, there's another ring here. And I said, no. There should be something else. It is really rare to have an outer ring. Now we have an inner ring, a new structure that wasn't supposed to be there. We haven't seen anything like that before. So what we need now to really pinpoint what is the nature of this inner ring and try to understand and make sense of its existence. Finding this system in the background by chance, it was an amazing experience. This galaxy is commonly referred to as Burçin's galaxy now. Discovering an extremely rare galaxy is a big deal. We find new common galaxies all the time. It is normal. Finding challenging and puzzling new systems are important because this pushes us to design new experiments and refine our models. Like dark matter, these extreme objects force us to think outside the box. When I decided I will study astronomy, I will go to America, I will do work for NASA, or I will go to space, become an astronaut. And when I talk about this, my parents were thinking, okay, yeah, you will do it. The most important part of being a scientist is not to give up. This is a process, and we are gathering drops of knowledge together, and each one at the end will inform our big questions. If you keep searching, space is full of mystery. So eventually you will find something new.